Welcome to my channel Nanovate. In this video, we will going to discuss about the reticular formation. The reticular formation that extends from the spinal cord up to the cerebellum is a major connection of the central nervous system. We will also going to discuss the connections of the reticular formation with the different areas of the central nervous system that includes the cerebrum, the cerebellum and the spinal cord. In this video, we will also going to discuss the major functions of reticular formation and the neuroanatomy of reticular formation. So starting from the diagram here, you can see this is the major position of reticular formation located in the area that is being deeply diffused in the brainstem. This reticular formation extends from the level of spinal cord, then it goes upward in the medulla, then it goes in the pons, and then at last in the midbrain, it reaches up to level of the thalamus and hypothalamus. This reticular formation is basically a network of nerve cells and nerve fibers that extend along the axis of the brainstem. This is being deeply diffused in the brainstem, and its major importance is to control the consciousness and the alertness of a body. The reticular formation has many connections. As I have told you, that it has many connections with the different areas of the central nervous system, that includes the afferent connections and the efferent connections of the reticular formation. Now, coming to the general arrangement of the reticular formation, that how this reticular formation is being arranged. If we take a cross section, we can see that these are the nuclear fibers and bundles, and how the nuclear groups are arranged to form the reticular formation. There are three groups of nucleus: the median nuclear group, the medial nuclear group, and the lateral nuclear group. These three nuclear groups, the median one having the intermediate length neurons, the medial one having the long neurons, and the lateral one having the small neurons. These three nuclear groups are arranged in such a way to form a reticular formation on the posterior side, or you can say deeply induced in the brainstem. Now, coming to the afferent and efferent connections of reticular formation with the other areas of central nervous system. Now, here if we focus this one diagram, we can see that this reticular formation that is going on from the spinal cord up to the level of midbrain and the thalamus and hypothalamus, this having various connections with the different part of central nervous system. So, starting from the afferent connections of the reticular formation, there are two major afferents: the spinoreticular fibers that are connecting the spinal cord to the reticular formation, and the cerebelloreticular fibers that will going to connect the cerebellum with the reticular formation. The third one is the major one here. You can see these fibers are going on. They are connecting the prefrontal lobe and the motor cortex with the reticular formation, and also the somatostatic or the parietal cortex with the reticular formation. So in this way, the cerebrum is also connected with the reticular formation and have afferent connections with it. Now, coming to the efferent connection, similarly, we can see that having the reticular formation have its efferent connection with the spinal cord. So you can say the reticulospinal tracts, and the second efferent is through the reticulobulbar fibers. What happens when these fibers go downward? They will synapse on the cranial nerve nuclei that are located in the midbrain, pons and medulla. So in this way, they will going to enter and synapse in that nuclei. So they are called as reticulobulbar nuclei, and control the activity of the nuclei. Now, the third connection of the efferent reticular fiber is with the autonomic nervous system. That is through the craniosacral outflow and the thoracolumbar outflow. In this way, it will going to control the autonomic nervous system activities. So, this was about the afferent and efferent. Now, we are going to discuss about the functions of the reticular formation. So this reticular formation is majorly important for the reticular activating system. This system that is important for the arousal and the level of consciousness is controlled by this reticular formation. The degree of the wakefulness depends on the degree of the activity of this reticular formation. So in this way, the pain signals, the activity signals, the excitatory signals of all the areas of the brain will be excited and being received by this reticular formation. So when the reticular formation is active, the human being is active, the brain is active. So it controls the level of consciousness and wakefulness. The second important function is that it controls the skeletal muscle activity by the reticulospinal tract that we have just discussed. The third one is that it controls the facial expressions, it controls the nuclear groups by the reticulobulbar fibers. Then it also controls your autonomic nervous system activity by controlling the emotions, by controlling the biological clock, the circadian rhythm. Why? Because of its connection with the hypothalamus as well in the superior direction. And also it has connections with the autonomic nervous system that we have discussed through the craniosacral or the thoracolumbar pathway. And this was all about the functions that the reticular formation perform in our body by connecting with the different part of the central nervous system. So this was all about the video. I hope you'll be explained well. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more. If you have any query, comment below, like, share and subscribe.